we're freaking podcasting.
Yes, it's been a minute. We've had a bad week. Not a bad week. We have not had a bad week. We've had a bad week of podcasting.
In the closet's been bad this week.
Yes,
it has. Not been consistent.
Wonder why. This week. What happened? Nothing even happened. I'm not even sure why. Maybe we just needed a break.
Maybe it's just a natural break.
Maybe it was a natural break. Sometimes you just got to listen to your body, your mind, and your soul.
Or we were just lazy.
Or we were just lazy.
I don't know.
No, I didn't get a lot of sleep this week. This was the week that this was my.
That's true.
Remember, I went
you
like
got haunted.
I didn't get haunted. Here we go. We just turned on the microphones, and he's yawning already.
I am. I don't know why.
I haven't seen you yawn all evening. But anyway, we did. We didn't have a haunting. No, we did not. But I was in my head.
You were in your head.
I was.
You were.
For 3 nights in a row.
You were.
I woke up freaked the freak out. Even to the point of one night. Did we already tell a story?
I have no idea because the last time we podcasted was probably last Sunday. So probably not.
Last Sunday?
Yes.
I don't know, but we were watching the stupid show and it freaked me out and I had to stop watching it and I woke up for 3 nights in a row right before the witching hour.
The witching hour.
And I had to stay awake and one night was really bad and Jeff had to come downstairs with me and then that's when that guy went out and decided to come drive by the house at 3:30 and just park in our cul-de-sac and smoke outside of his car.
Yes, with his car running, lights
which
on.
Could be a normal everyday occurrence for him, and we just are never up at that time. We don't see it. Maybe that's just normal.
Maybe.
I don't know. Anyway, so I started leaving a few lights on in our room, and it's helped me sleep. And I refrained from watching that crazy show.
Yeah, it seems like you're doing better now.
So, anyway, it's the end of the weekend. We had a great weekend, and we had fun. I got to take Saturday off. And
ooh,
we
did have fun.
Yeah, we had a good weekend. I worked Friday night and then Saturday again we took off and went to a friend's house and did Cinco de Mayo. That's what she called it.
Cinco de Mayo.
Olympics.
Olympics.
There was cornhole. There was ladder golf. There was can jam.
There was flip cup tic-tac-toe.
Bocce ball.
Pepperoni rolls.
Darts. Pepperoni rolls. That was not an event.
No, it felt like an event.
A little bit of Twister and some hammer and nail game. Jeff, I think next time he's going to take someone else because come to find out, I'm really not that great at yard games.
Yeah.
Oh, there was, did I say cornhole? Did I say that first?
I don't know. It's right. Way too far down the line for me to remember.
I'm not that good at yard. Gosh, would you stop yawning? It makes me feel a certain type of way.
I don't know why I'm so yawny.
Is there something on your microphone that's putting off a smell?
Are you trying to poison me?
That's making you yawn because, like, it's all the time. Anyway, I'm not very good at yard games, and I think ladder golf we won once.
We won ladder golf, and we won the first round of ladder golf.
Oh, we
first
won cornhole
round of cornhole.
Once. Yeah, we almost won beer. What is it called? Beer pong?
We almost won beer
I
pong.
I carried us in that.
Yeah, you did.
But
we
anyway.
We should have won ladder golf.
We should have. And if
probably
I would have.
Probably cornhole too.
And if I would have taken my shoes off, I probably would have been a lot better at Twister.
Probably.
But I had my socks on. I took my shoes off, but I had my socks on, and there was one move, and my feet slipped, and I went rolling in the grass.
Amateur mistake.
I didn't see you over there. Oh, and we did musical chairs as well, and some chairs were broken, some lawn
they
chairs.
They were, yes, that went on
those
the
those are not steady chairs to be musical chairs.
No.
You need to have, like, chairs like these metal ones or, like, kitchen chairs, I feel like.
Hadn't played musical chairs for a long time.
Well, last time you were there, did you all not play last time, or did Sarah do
it? I
think
Sarah did it last time.
But and then last time I was there with you, you did it.
Well, there you go.
I'm not a musical chairs kind of girl. I don't want to have to be.
I don't think anybody's a musical chairs type of person.
How do you know?
I just don't think that people go, That's what I do. That's my talent. Musical chairs. I'm really good.
Well, we need to brush up on cornhole and ladder golf and can jam because we don't have ladder golf anymore, but Dad's going to make us some cornhole boards.
Yeah, we should be able to get better.
We have a flat surface in front of our house. We could practice. Same thing with can jam.
We could stand out there in the evening until it's dark drinking alcohol.
That's
beverages.
Right. We could instead of, yeah, like right now, we should be playing
and
can
to
jam.
To get ourselves to play it where we don't drink Monday through Thursday, we'll say the only way we can drink is if we're working on our game.
I like that rule. So let's start tomorrow evening.
We'll be out there. The lights will be out. It'll be 10:30.
We should have played this evening because the kids are home. Maddie's here. Brooke's here. Nate's here. Avery's here.
It's true.
We could have all played. Anyway, Brooke probably shouldn't. But nonetheless, it was fun. We had a great time and that's all that matters, right? And then we came home and Jeff fell asleep at 10 p.m. It was great.
I did.
But anyway.
I don't know why. I guess it's the day drinking got me.
I mean, I guess, if you want to call it that, but whatever.
Had to be.
I day drank too when I didn't fall asleep.
I can't help that you react differently to alcohol than I do.
Apparently. And then today we went hiking for the first time in Fayetteville. It was so nice.
We did.
And I was super proud of myself.
It was a big deal.
It was a big deal.
I was a little shocked.
Were you shocked?
Mm-hmm.
Were you really?
I was, yes. I did not think you'd go out there. You just weren't as neurotic today as you were the first trip.
Listen, sometimes I'm in different moods.
Right.
Sometimes if I get in my head, then I will react as such. Like, okay, so last time we did this hike, it's called Long Point. Look it up. It's in Fayetteville, West Virginia, Long Point Trail. You'll see pictures and you'll see what I'm talking about. You get to the end and you're at a point. It's a big rock. And it's pretty much a point.
Beautiful, beautiful views.
Beautiful.
It narrows to get to the rock. It's not like you walk. You've got to kind of shimmy over some little narrow passageways. And on the sides of you, it just drops off to your death.
Yeah, because there's no barrier at all.
No, this is hiking.
There's no barrier.
This is not an amusement park.
There's no stopping. Like, you know, sometimes when you go... Like, I know this. The one time I went skiing, there was those orange fences for, like, some sort of a barrier.
Yes.
To even just catch a fall. It wasn't even, there's nothing. When I say nothing, I mean absolutely nothing. So if you accidentally trip, or if you get a little dizzy, or if you're like me and have really bad peripheral vision, then you might think that you're closer to the center than you really are, and your foot could slip, and then, I mean, I'll just be seeing you later. So the very first time we did this, I was in my head about it, and I got panicky, and I got anxiety. I had a very, very mild, like, anxiety attack. So I had to stay back on this rock and let before it narrowed, because I saw how it narrowed, and I saw how high up, and I was like, okay, I'll stay right here this time. But today I was feeling a certain type of way, I guess, and I was like, I'm going to go on this narrow part, and I'm going to go to the point that before you go way out into the point. And I went out. I didn't go all the way out to the point. I didn't make it all the way.
But you got on the rock.
But I got on the rock, and I made it further than I did last time, and that's a success.
I counted a success.
Doing better than you did last time, or going further than you did the time before, is a success.
It is a success.
So maybe next time I go, I'll go on out a little bit more. You know what? Honestly, another reason why I didn't want to go out a little bit further is there were so many people there.
There's a lot of people.
And there's there. A little kids. And it was making me nervous. And so I'm like, I'm going to be so nervous with these kids around. I'm going to fall off the side of the mountain because I'm trying to be careful with these kids. There was just too many people.
Yeah, it's like the guy, too, with the drone. I noticed he was walking around watching his drone.
I know. It was driving me crazy.
I'm like, dude, you might want to watch where your feet are.
And I don't know where they were from. We tried to talk to him, but they were speaking a different language. They were speaking a different language, right? And we tried to say something to them, and they were speaking a different language, and we were like, oh, they don't speak our language. And then all of a sudden to his kids, he goes, okay, let's go.
Yeah,
I was like, what?
Really weird.
He didn't want to talk to us, I don't think.
They were speaking French, weren't they?
I feel like it might have been, or German. I don't think it was French, actually, because I can hear French, because I used to take French. I can't speak it or know what they were saying, but I can hear the language. I think it was German.
I didn't hear any ugh. Or any of that stuff.
I don't know what it was.
Anyway.
I don't know. But anyway, so I was.
Maybe that's the only American they know is Let's Go Kids.
I was proud of myself. So, and it was
you
fun.
You did good. You hiked well. It was a good hike. We didn't just do Long Point. We did the Butcher's what?
Branch Trail.
Butcher's Branch Trail, and then it connects to Long Point Trail, and the Butcher's Branch Trail.
There was nobody on that trail.
Nobody. Like we could maybe have totally. One?
Here we go.
Banged it up there on that trail. There we go. We would have thought about it. We could have butchered that.
Oh my gosh.
And the butcher. You know what I'm saying?
You're freaking. You know what I'm saying? Are any of these sounds like the boom boom? I don't remember what these sounds do. I think it's D. That was super.
Why is that so? Oh, it's on 10. That might.
Sorry, you guys.
Dang.
We just was. There it is.
There it is. That I should be using that all the time.
We just woke everybody up. Anyway, and then we went to this coffee place and got a coffee, and it was really nice. So. That was our weekend.
Cathedral
Coffee. And that was our weekend in a nutshell, basically.
It was a big weekend.
And now the week starts all over again. Joy.
Joy to the week. It was fun. It was a fun weekend.
Yeah, it was.
I wonder what the dog's thinking right now with all our equipment on.
Malibu, do you want to say something?
You want to talk?
She's like, get that microphone out of my face. She doesn't speak, Jeff. She doesn't. Only
she's
when somebody walks
to me
by.
Because she's wagging
her
tail.
Oh, my gosh. Jeff and this dog. Y'all listen. Jeff likes this dog, Malibu, better than he likes me, I believe. So.
No, that's not true.
You don't pet me like you pet her.
I pet you. I grab your booty and smack it.
Oh, that's not petting.
Yeah, that's a way a man pets.
No, that's not.
If I walked by you and didn't do it.
Petting is like patting and being like affectionate and sensual.
I do that sometimes.
Butt grabbing or butt smacking is more sexual.
I learned a lesson today.
Do you think sexual and sensual are two different things?
Sure they are.
What's the difference?
Sensual is more, I don't know. Is sensual more, maybe it's not different. Maybe it just sounds different.
I think it's different. What do you think it is?
Sensual is... Sexual sounds like it's probably more brass, a little more rough around the edges. Sensual is more romantic.
I feel
but
like
sexual,
that too.
Like it's you're getting to the same place but in a different way.
Yeah, I think it has to do with sexual
too. If you had a more sensual session.
Okay, so what does it mean to be sensual? Sensuous, sensual, luxurious, voluptuous means
I like all those.
Mean relating to or providing pleasure through gratification of the senses.
Mm-hmm. I like
sensuous
it.
Implies gratification of the senses for the sake of aesthetic pleasure.
Wait, aesthetic pleasure?
Mm-hmm. What does it mean when a woman is sensual? Sensuality as a sexual signature is the ability to fulfill.
There you go. That's sensual right there.
Ability to fully experience one's senses. Smelling, tasting, seeing, hearing, touching, and feeling combine to awaken the body and can strongly contribute to a sexual connection. I think that's what we were saying. Like, I think it's more of a romantic thing, but I think in the end, you're going to get to a sexual game.
I'm thinking the first thing that comes to mind for me is feathers.
Feathers?
Like the sensual, like to get me to that place, you're tickling me with feathers. Like you're slowly rubbing them on my body.
Wow.
And you're whispering in my ear, you're right. You're right. And I'm just getting so worked up.
Wow.
Because one, I'm right. And two, I've got feathers on me.
You're right. You being right gets you worked up. Then you're worked up all the time. You were right today and it really pissed me off. I thought we were supposed to go one way on the trail and he said the other. And I thought for sure I was right. And I was wrong. Anyway, I think that butt smacking and grabbing is more sexual than sensual.
I think you're right.
I think sensual would be
you
like
this.
You come up to me and like you give me a little massage, or maybe you just like rub my arm like lightly, or like play with my hair,
or just run my finger down your spine.
But running by and giving me a quick smack on the butt—that's just kind of flirty. Like it's like there's nothing sensual about that at all.
I agree. I happen to agree on this one.
Not that I don't mind. I don't mind that you do it.
Oh, you love it.
I'm not saying not to do it. I'm just saying for the definition. You know what I mean?
Yeah, when we're talking definitions, I think that you're right. I think sensual is more of a like coming up behind you, rubbing your shoulders.
Yeah.
putting on some music and grinding up on
you. Oh, here we go.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, slowly, I know what you're saying.
Though. Yeah.
That's sensual.
What you doing? Where are you at?
You got put a little plans. Johnny Gill on. Get a little.
No, don't ever do that.
He
Johnny
was
Gill.
Sexy.
Ugh.
Johnny Gill back in the 90s.
You know who to put on if you need me to get in a certain type of way. Does it ever. Oh, I mean, you. Listen, Johnny Gill, my butt. Whatever.
Johnny Gill,
man. Ew, come on. You can
Johnny
do better than that.
Johnny Gill. Bobby Brown?
No. You seriously know
wait,
who
wait,
I'm
wait,
talking
wait,
about.
Wait.
If you want to be sensual
no,
and
I know,
getting
no,
in the
I,
mood.
I'm trying to remember the name of the group. Color Me Bad.
Not Color Me Bad.
Color Me Bad was so sexy back in the day.
I want to sex you up.
Yep, there it is. Color Me Bad. Oh, God.
I sing
guys.
Way too much on this. No, that's not the right answer.
John Legend. Wah, wah, wah. Just kidding. She's looking at me like she's going to murder me.
Wow.
She loves her some John Legend.
Well, so what? Who gets
Maroon
you?
Maroon 5.
Ooh, yeah.
John Legend and Maroon 5.
Mm.
She just wants to put on a mix.
Yes. I mean, honestly.
That's sensual.
I like them.
Yes, you do.
I do. Who, what group gets you in the kind of like, ooh, I feel that. I don't think you have a relationship with music like I do in that way. I don't.
No, I don't really have a relationship with music that
You're
way.
More of a podcast or guy, I feel
yeah,
like.
Yeah, but that doesn't get me off either. It's not getting me
not.
All turned on like, oh my God.
I think it is. I think Joe Rogan does that to you.
It gets me close, but
I'll
not
be like
not
Jeff's
that.
Sitting there with his ear pods on and his eyes are rolling back in the back of his head and I'm like, oh, he's listening to Joe Rogan again.
Yeah.
Or Dr. Drew.
I don't listen to Dr. Drew as much anymore. Really? I do like Dr. Drew After Dark.
Are
I
you
just
mad
haven't
at him?
No, I've been getting into some other podcasts
oh,
later lately.
Oh, some strange.
Yeah, I've been
ooh,
getting some strange.
Who?
I like Wondery. Wondery is a brand of podcasts.
Wondery?
Yeah, it's a
How
brand.
How do you spell that?
WONDERY.
Wondery.
Yeah, it's the brand, and they have all kinds of stuff. They have stuff from crime to, oh I listen to several, like the one I told you about I was listening to now. That's more like a, it's almost like a documentary about something that happened in the past.
Oh my gosh, that sounds so terrible.
It's amazing.
It's so it's terrible. Amazing. All that sounds awful
and,
to me.
And they do recount, like in God We Lust, I told you about that one. It's the Jerry Falwell Jr. over at Liberty.
Yeah.
Getting his rocks off. No, she was getting her rocks off. He was involved in it and they were enjoying themselves and they got in trouble.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because they don't let kids on the campus to have fun or hold hands, but they were doing dirty, dirty stuff with some mm-hmm. random people.
I just don't get into podcasts like that.
Well.
That's just not for me. It's okay. It's just not for me.
I know, and I don't get into, I love music.
No, I know you do.
But I don't get turned on by it.
Well, I'm not saying I get turned on by music. I'm just saying that, like, music really speaks to me, and, like, lyrics, and, like, you know what I mean? Like, oh, what is this dog doing?
Getting close.
She needs a bath is what she needs.
Honestly, I tore my finger up.
How'd you tear your finger up?
I have no idea. That's what happens when you go in the woods.
I went in the woods and I don't have anything tore up.
Yeah, we'll see. I just noticed it.
Oh. I do feel a little burn or something. Like I
Here's
a little
the
sunburn.
Thing. I like those, not artists, but that music too. I like the artists, but I like those music too. That music too for when we're hanging out in a sensual way. Doesn't bother me.
Right.
That it's a dude.
I mean, it has nothing
it's
to do
just
about.
It's the sound.
Right.
You know? And there's no real women that do that. I guess there probably are for somebody, but.
What?
The only woman that I can think of, voice and style, that makes me think that's sexy.
Yeah.
Well, there's some, but this one, Nelly Furtado. She's always done it for me.
I don't think she's around anymore.
I don't think she is either, but I can still play Promiscuous, and it's a great song. And it does something about her voice. She's got a sexy voice. And I don't even think, like, really, it's you know what I mean? Because sometimes people have sexy voices, but they're not that your style, or they're not that sexy. You see them, and you're like, man.
Their voice is better.
Their voice is better. It's something about their swagger.
Some people just have a voice that's like, you know what I mean?
I do.
Yeah.
Yes.
I get what you're saying. Wonder what happened to her anyway.
She probably made her money and rolled off into the sunset.
You think that's what happened? Mm-hmm. She made her money and rolled up in it. Where is Nelly Furtado now? How do you say her last name? Furtado? I feel like I'm saying like frittata. That's not how you say it.
Yeah, it's like a dish. Man, I peeled that off now. It's going to hurt like a son of a bitch.
Nelly Furtado. Where is she now? I'm asking you, where is she now?
In the basement?
You wish.
I don't know where she's at now. I thought you were asking your phone. Why would I know?
Well, I mean, since she turned you on, I figured you maybe follow her.
No, I never even really think about her. Just when the songs come on, I'm like, her voice is good.
Let's see, where is she now? I'm looking it up. Where is Nelly Furtado now? She may not be in the spotlight anymore, but her net worth is still insane. She looks better with hair. I'm just going to say that.
Most people do.
I don't know. There's some people that...
Females, that is.
Instead of focusing on music and acting, the pop star has been involved in a lot of philanthropy. Oh, how do you say that name? I mean, that word. Hold on. Philanthropic work. She's a philanthropist. How do you say that?
Philanthropist.
Philanthropist or something. She is a member of the charity Artists Against Racism, even hosting fundraising events with fellow celebs Justin Timberlake and Alicia Keys.
Good for her.
So, I didn't know that happened. It says that she was one of the artists who got their work destroyed in the 2008 Universal Studios fire.
I didn't know there was a Universal fire.
Anyway. So she's just on doing fundraising work and being an amazing person.
Philanthropist.
Is that right? Philanthropist.
Philanthropist. She's a philanthropist.
Right. So there you go. That's where she is now. In case you guys don't know. So she's not really dropping the bars right now. Jeff,
she's not dropping the bars.
Oh, there goes Malibu wanting to
here
be on the podcast.
Go. Malibu, get over here.
She's not gonna listen to you.
Malibu. Over.
He acts like she's going to listen. She's not going to listen. It's nice. Nice try, though.
Sit down,
nice
bro.
Nice try. There were some dogs on the trail today I was really jealous of. One is a dog that I want. And if I ever get another dog, which I probably won't, but if I do, I want a King Charles. And there was a King Charles on the trail today. And then there was dogs that obeyed their masters on the trail today without a leash. And I was like, my dogs would never do that.
It's very impressive.
They're wild and crazy. Wild and crazy.
Crazy and wild.
So anyway, they would never behave like that. So we could never take our dogs on a hike. You hear me, Malibu? You're never going on a hike.
She can go on a hike. Why would we not take her? She could have a good time
on
a hike.
Oh my God. I'm telling you guys.
You know what we need?
We'll take Callie. Callie, I think,
no,
would be.
No. Callie's neurotic. She'll go crazy. She'll go,
Malibu will bark at everything. Callie won't bark.
Not. She'll get used to it. It'll take her two or three trips.
Why does he love this dog more than the other? It's like having a kid where you actually admit to loving more than the other. I don't have any kids
They're dumb as rocks. They have no idea that I like one over the other. Like, I don't think Malibu knows that I like her over Callie.
Oh, I think
Callie
she knows.
Callie does not know that I like her over Callie.
I think they both know. And
Do
if
you
they
know
don't,
Malibu?
She's
you
like,
barely know your freaking name.
She knows her name.
Malibu.
See, I told you. She just sees something next door that she likes better than you.
I doubt that's it. I think she's trying to protect me from
mm-hmm.
something next door,
mm-hmm.
is what the truth is.
Mm-hmm.
Is she's like, I've got you, bro. You don't have to worry about anything. I'm just going to bark my head off at that noise over there.
Whatever. I don't even.
What's up
well,
with the freaking
anyway.
Dog on the other side of the holler? Just barking like crazy.
The dog's always barking. And the rooster's always crowing.
Well, it's messing with our podcast.
You are going to have some haters. Can't wait. So, are we getting vaccinated this week? I'm just so torn still.
Yeah, I know.
I'm still so torn. When I think I have my mind made up, then I just stop in my tracks.
I hate to ruin a streak is my thing. It's really not about being torn. It's just I like streaks.
I'm torn because the only reason, and I'm telling you the only only reason I'm getting vaccinated is because we're having a grandbaby in a few months. And I'd feel terrible. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the only reason. The only reason I'm getting vaccinated. Not because the government's telling me to. But at the same time, would I really bring... I mean, I don't know.
Do you think that the babies can get it?
I think so. Nah. Let me look that up.
You know what? And you know what? It's going to be fun to see if I get it, because I passed a bottle of wild turkey around a party.
Oh, my gosh.
Night.
He drank after like 12 people yesterday. It was so gross. And then he brought it home and asked me if I wanted some. I'm like, no, bro. I'll just get my own bottle if I want to drink.
Alcohol, it cleanses itself.
No, that is such a lie.
And now it's in the freezer. You know there's no germs.
That's a lie.
Cold,
I don't care.
Temperatures.
I saw everybody who drank out
germs.
Of it, and I'm not doing it.
I'm not sick yet, so we'll see.
COVID-19 is uncommon in newborns born to mothers who had COVID-19 during pregnancy. Some newborns have tested positive shortly after birth. It is unknown if these newborns got the virus before, during, or after. Most newborns who tested positive had mild or no symptoms and recovered. So there you go.
You know why? Because COVID-19 is 2020's flu strand. It's just the strand of the
probably.
Flu for that year. Don't get mad, people. I'm just having fun.
Anyway,
usually
it says
girl.
In children, it causes mild symptoms and usually no harm. So, I mean, I don't know, but I don't know. It just makes me so frustrated. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't understand. Like, it's. The vaccine was put together so quickly and was distributed so widely that it's scary for me.
Yes.
It's scary for me. Now, I'm glad.
And you're a middle-aged, very healthy, well-kept exercise. You take care of yourself. You get the proper nutrition. There's zero reason for you to take it.
I don't know. I mean, I tend to agree
with you.
If you
just want to get sick.
Well, here's the thing.
You know, let me go ahead and I haven't been sick from COVID or anything else. So let me go get a shot and possibly be sick for 24 hours.
I mean, it's just a short period of time.
I don't want to be
but
sick for a short period
you know, people are always like, you put everything else in your body, you're scared. I know, but like the stuff that I put in my body have been around for a while. I know that wine, I know alcohol has been around for a while. I know all these other vaccinations that I had when I was younger, they've been around for a while, A, and B, I didn't have a choice. Yeah, I vaccinated my kids, but those vaccines have been around forever.
Yeah,
these companies didn't just whip something up in the lab real quick and 6 months later are distributing them to everybody in the world.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm going to go... 2 months after it's been, you know, or two or three or four, however many months it's been since it's been widely available, I'm just going to let you stick that in my arm. I'm a little leery of it. I cannot help it.
Right.
I'm not trying to be a certain type of way.
No.
I'm not trying to be anti. I'm not
you're
that
not
kind of way.
You're an anti-vaxxer.
I'm not.
I'm not an anti-vaxxer. I'm anti-fast vaxxer, I think.
I need some more time to see, you know what I'm saying? But then at the same time, I don't want to be, you know, here's the thing. If they would say.
I don't want to be inconvenienced.
If they would say, if you get the vaccination and you can carry around this stupid ass card, which y'all look stupid. Anyway, I shouldn't have said that. I don't take it back. It does kind of look silly. I'm not going to take a picture of me and my card and show it to you guys. It's a private thing if I do it. Anyway, what's my point? Oh, if they say. You do not have to wear a mask anywhere anymore.
You shouldn't. It's retarded.
Then I may even consider it more and just keep a handy dandy little card available, just like my driver's license. And if somebody
you might get a lanyard
needs to see it.
On your chest.
Oh yes, you know how I love lanyards, and that way I can show you that I am a vaccinator. But you know what I mean? Until then, I don't know. I mean, I keep saying this week I'm going to do it. And then the week goes by and I talked myself out of it again. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So, that being said, But at the same time, I just wish I could just do it and just be, okay, y'all leave me alone. I'm vaccinated. I can feel confident to go around my granddaughter and know that I'm not going to give her anything. But then watch, you all wait and see. A year from now, they're going to be like, well, we need a booster. And we're going to have to go get a booster. And here we are, going in hordes to the clinic to get a booster.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I know it's going on.
So.
It's crazy.
Oh, it is crazy.
It's crazy.
It really is. So, anyway, that's that. We'll keep you posted on what we do. Because you'll have to hear it here. Because it'll be over. It will be a cold day in hell. And pigs will be flying if I post a picture of myself and a vaccination card.
I'm going to have mine.
And I'm a selfie queen.
I'm going to put it on my face. And I'm going to just... I might get a tattoo. I might have them tattoo my card on me.
I think that would be amazing.
That would be cool. And then I can just go around and go, coronavirus?
That would be amazing. But no, I'm just kidding. I mean, I am a selfie queen, but it's just... I voted and I didn't need to post my voting sticker. And no. If I vaccinate, I don't need to post my vaccination thing. I try to keep that kind of stuff off of, like, I try to keep my social media, like, as controversy free.
Controversy free.
Does that make sense? I never talk about politics. You'll never see me talk politics. You'll never see me talk about the coronavirus. The only thing I've said about the coronavirus on social media was recently on TikTok. And I did a TikTok saying, tell me you're tired of wearing masks without telling me you're tired of wearing masks, just to see if I could get some things. But I don't really bring it. I might bring it on the podcast, or if I do like a live, we'll talk about it. But like, I don't use my social media platform. Not that I have a huge platform, but I'm just saying to talk politics, to talk religion, I don't like to talk controversial current events because I try to keep it light. I try to keep it entertaining and fun. You know what right. I'm saying? Not that it's bad if you do, because maybe that's what your social media is for.
If you're into it, then go for it.
Well, sure. Yeah. Because some people like that kind of stuff. But for me, I just try to keep it fitness, fun, family, selfies, fun pictures, and fun content.
Right.
So telling everybody that I got vaccinated by posting a picture with my card, I don't need to do that because I see people doing that.
That's not your style.
And I just see responses, and it's just like, whether people are for it or against it, I'm not asking for, you're asking for comments if you do that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so I don't need
some haters.
I don't need all that. I don't need it. I'm going to frame it though if I do it. No, I'm just kidding. I'm really not.
I'm going to go for a long walk to find that dog.
Jeff, that dog's been around for years.
I didn't notice it much until
tonight. Oh my gosh, I notice it all the time.
Well, you're much
just
more
like the
observant.
Rooster. No, because I spend more time out here than you do.
That's probably
that dog
it.
Barking does not bother me at all. This one does.
Well, she's being a good
girl. Because that one's barks off afar.
Barks off afar.
Barks off afar.
Barks off afar.
If I don't hear the roosters here pretty in the next couple of days, I'm going to start worrying about them.
Might have ate them.
Possibly. All right, I'm going to go shower this hike off, so I got to go.
This is it. Good night and farewell.
Peace out.